God, you have bestowed on us paschal remedies. Endow your people with heavenly gifts, so that possessed of perfect freedom, they may rejoice in heaven over what gladdens them now on earth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter said to the Jewish people, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made him both Lord and Christ, that Jesus whom you crucified." Now, when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The gospel of the Lord, or the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and to preserve them in spite of famine. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us who have put our hope in you. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Mary Magdalene stayed outside the tomb weeping. And as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet, where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary went and announced the good news to the disciples. "I have seen the Lord," and then reported what he had told her. The Gospel of the Lord. praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. At the beginning of a baptismal ceremony for infants or of children, the very first thing that happens is the priest or deacon asks the parents, "What name do you give to the child?" And it's a bit disconcerting or disorienting for pastors or for parents, because they're often like, "Well, Father, you know the name. It's written down right there." Or when I've done a baptism for a family member, they're like, "My gosh, you know the name of the child. You heard it when we announced who it was." But the purpose isn't for record keeping or to help me to remember with my poor memory. The purpose is to establish and reaffirm this fact that God knows this individual, this infant, this child by name. When the parents say, "The child's name is John or Teresita or Jose or Mary," it's a reminder that God knows this child, that person, us. He knows us by name. There is a personal relationship there. We see that come to the fore in today's gospel. Mary is weeping, overcome with grief at the tomb of Jesus. And she sees this person she assumes is the gardener, and he calls her by name. He says, "Mary," and she realizes this is the teacher. She responds, "Rabboni," dear teacher, dear friend. He knows her by name. In these difficult days, as we mourn, as we grieve, as we are anxious, as we worry, as we struggle, it is a wonderful reminder. God knows us by name, calls us by name, and stands with us to give us strength to overcome our fear, our anxieties. We pray as we're doing right now. We pray in order to reestablish, reaffirm, and strengthen that relationship with the Lord. As he called Mary by name, he calls you, he calls me by name, affirming his deep and abiding love for us. An interesting thing happens in the gospel. Mary grabs Jesus by the feet. The sense is that she is the one who has anointed the Lord's feet in previous verses of the gospel. And Jesus says to her, "Do not cling to me, but go to my brothers and announce the good news." And a lot has been written about that. Why would Jesus say that? And I think in this particular case, Jesus is saying, "You remember me from olden days. You remember me from days past. There's something new here. Don't stay stuck in the old days, but live with a newness of life. You be the one to go and announce to my brothers, to the apostles, the good news that I am risen from the dead." The word apostle means one who is sent, and in particular, one who is sent to share the good news. We know there's the 12 apostles, but St. Paul is also another apostle. In the early church, and also affirmed by St. Thomas Aquinas in the Middle Ages, Mary Magdalene was always called the apostle among the apostles, the first one to receive the good news of Christ's resurrection, the first one to announce the good news of Christ living among us. Pope Francis affirmed that in the year 2016 and made Mary's Day that we celebrate in July, July 22nd, a feast day on par with the other apostles. She was faithful in announcing the good news. And that is our calling. We are to be apostolic. We say the church in the creed is apostolic. We are to announce the good news of Christ risen from the dead. Christ conquers sin. Christ conquers death. Christ is our health. It is right to celebrate today as we do, and remembering in particular Mary of Magdalene, her faithful witness. Let us ask her to intercede for us so that we may faithfully witness the good news as she did, that Christ truly is risen. He is risen indeed. With confidence that God is always with us, let us offer him our prayers. For all members of our church, may the risen Lord inspire our witness to the gospel each day, we pray to the Lord. For our national and local leaders, especially during these times, may God guide them in working to address the needs of the most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord. For those who are discouraged by illness, may God bring them full healing of mind and body, we pray to the Lord. We pray for all caregivers, for educators, for parents, for workers in these difficult times. May the Lord be their strength and help them each and every day, we pray to the Lord. For catechists and those who minister to this faith community in the liturgy and in other ways, may God bless their efforts, we pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed, may they be welcomed into the heavenly kingdom by the communion of the saints, we pray to the Lord. Father, we entrust our prayers to you in the holy name of your Son, Jesus, risen from the dead, and who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, sisters, pray, brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to praise you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, for he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they sing. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gregory, our Bishop, and all the clergy, religious, and your faithful everywhere. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, especially Mary Magdalene, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare now to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church," and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to each other a sign of Christ's peace, or take the time to pray now for peace in our homes, our community, our church and world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Hear us, Almighty God, and as you have bestowed on your family the perfect grace of baptism, so prepare their hearts for the reward of eternal happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.